telling us about a tragic boat event in Nigeria.
After that, Adrian Asornio tells us about how thousands of dead fish washed up on the Texas shoreline.
Oh my god. Finally, we have a new installment of Global Conflicts.
All of that and much more on the last episode of Flyer News for the year.
Now let's roll it. Good morning, Flyers! Today is day 6 with periods running D-A-B-E-G. I'm Mikey Anastasi.
And I'm Mary Carney.
So, Mary, what you doing over the summer?
Oh, I'm going to be on the Cape.
Ooh, nice. What are you going to do on there?
You know, the basics. Swimming, going on boat rides, tanning, some more swimming.
You gotta be careful there. Be careful on the boat one. If you're going boating, I heard there's a terrible boating accident in Nigeria.
Really? What happened?
Well, I don't know much of it, but let's send it over to Ben Hunt to tell you.
A boat that was carrying people returning from a wedding capsized in northern Nigeria, killing 100 people. The search for survivors has intensified in recent days. The boat capsized in a river in Nigeria. There were around 100 people on the boat, and almost all of them died after the ship sank, because it happened at roughly 3 a.m. local time. This meant that the local residents in Nigeria did not see what had happened and were unable to report it until the next morning. Funerals have been held for more than 60 of the victims of this horrible accident. Most of the passengers were not wearing life vests. The passengers on the boat came from two villages in Nigeria. In May of 2021, a boat sank on the same river and around the same area. As many as 160 people died in that accident. This accident that happened on Monday is horrible, as well as the one that happened in 2021, and we can only hope for the best for all the families of the victims.
It is so horrible that this happened on their wedding day. A day that is supposed to bring joy that ended so tragically. From Flyer News, I'm Ben Hunt, and have a great day.
So, I don't know about you, Mary, but I still love going fishing.
Oh, I love fishing too. Although, I do have to say, the boat ride out is the best part.
Yeah, good thing you're not fishing in Texas. I might as well be fishing on the moon like DreamWorks. You might have a hard time finding fish.
What do you mean?
Adrian Asornio can tell us. All right, now let's roll his video.
This past weekend, thousands of dead fish have started to wash up on Texas shores. The fish primarily have been washing up on the Gulf Coast Beach, just 65 miles south of Houston. According to the Texas Parks and Wildlife Department, low dissolved oxygen was the root cause for the event. Low oxygen levels are common in the summer when temperatures rise, making it so the fish can't take in enough oxygen underwater. The high bacterial levels and dangerous fins have caused local officials to urge swimmers to stay away from the coast. Cleanup efforts started on Friday and ended on Sunday, when the last of the remains deteriorated to the point of being shredded skeletons. Water samples from the Gulf, Intracoastal Canal, and the Brazos River, which feed into the coast, were found to have almost no dissolved oxygen in them, local officials said. There's no evidence of dead fish being related to any chemical spill of sorts. It's good to see that this didn't affect residents too badly. With that, I'm Adrian Asornio, and back to the desk.
A man from Massachusetts claimed a Powerball ticket worth of $50,000. The catch is that he claimed this ticket only 9 days before it was set to expire. Danny Thomas of Hudson told the Massachusetts State Lottery that he and his wife located the ticket after hearing that the cash prize was still unclaimed on the radio. He decided to check the Powerball website and soon came to the conclusion that he had won the jackpot. Just yesterday, Thomas went down to the Bryan Tree Regional Office and claimed his winnings to say that this man got lucky. Got lucky is a huge understatement.
State officials asked the public to help reporting wild turkey sightings. Officials said, quote, "Every year from June 1st to August 31st, wild turkey reports from the public help biologists determine productivity, compare long-term reproductive stress, and estimate fall harvest potential," end quote. The biologists look at the data from past years and compare it to the trends. If you spot a turkey, remember not to go near it to ensure your and their safety. If you would like to participate in the surveys, you can look up Wild Turkey Observation Survey.
Oh yeah, it's that time again. Time again for the best segments. Global conflicts.
I heard there was a special guest on this episode.
Ooh, yeah, there is. And this is truly the last global conflicts video of the year.
That's crazy how fast the year went by.
Yeah, it went by so fast. But in the meantime, let's roll that video.
There is one sign the Soviets can make that would be unmistakable. Open this gate.
Hello, and welcome back to today's episode of Global Conflicts. For today's episode, I bring my buddy Conmar the Deep. Conmar here is going to tell us about the upcoming situation in Russia and Ukraine. It's only his predictions, though, because obviously the future is unknown. It's still a very active war, so if you ever have a chance to go check it out in the news, I would. There's a lot you can learn from it. What are your predictions, Katie?
I personally believe that this war might come to an end soon, especially that the amount of number that people have died, the amount of damages caused in Ukraine itself, and the amount of, like, in general, how much is harming our society overall. And I feel like the government might come, like, both of the governments might come to a realization that it's better to come to an agreement or, like, something. Or just find a way to end this war instead of keep on continuing and let the damages roll up and keep on increasing, because this is really benefiting no one and it's just better to end it off soon.
I agree, Conmar. Those are some real points, heartfelt. I thank you for that. To end today's episode, I want to ask Conmar about any news going on in India.
Well, there's not really nothing special happening, but recently there was a big train crash because of, like, the alignment of tracks, and it was really devastating since, like, there was a lot of deaths that occurred, and sorry about that, and many people died from that, but I feel like the government and a lot of people got a lot to learn from it. But at the end of the day, even though it was really devastating, we got something to learn from it, and we just wish for the families that went through this. I hope.
Thank you, Colin, for that update. Anyways, I'm Zach Steiglitz.
I'm Penrody Fingernella.
Thank you for listening. Let's take it back to the desk and have a good summer. It's the last video, so thank you for watching. See you later.
Well, unfortunately, that's all the time we've got for today's episode of Flyer News. You can rewatch this and other broadcasts again on our YouTube channel or on the FEC TV tab on the school's website.
Also, check us out on Instagram and Facebook at Birmingham High Studios.
But don't move just yet, okay? Stay in your seats. Because we have the latest edition of The Early Bird hosted by Ben DeGroat and Zach Schneider.
From Flyer News, I'm Mary Carney.
And I'm Mikey Anastasi. Have a wonderful Wednesday, FHS, and have a fantastic finals week and an even better summer vacation.
suicidal, suicidal. When you say it's over, damn all these beautiful girls. They only wanna do you dirt. They'll have you suicidal, suicidal. When they say it's over. See, it started at the park. Used to chill after dark. Ooh, when you took my heart. When we fell apart, 'cause we both thought that love lasts forever.
Lasts forever.
They say we too young to get ourselves sprung. Oh, we didn't care. We made it very clear. And they also said that we couldn't last together.
Last together.
See, it's very divine. You're one of a kind, but you mash up my mind. They get declined, oh Lord. My baby is driving me crazy. You're way too beautiful, girl. That's why it'll never work. You have me suicidal, suicidal. When you say it's over, damn all these beautiful girls. They only wanna do you. In 99, watching movies all the time. Ooh, and I went away for doing my first crime. And I never thought that we was gonna see each other.
See each other.
And then I came out, mommy moved me down south. Ooh, I ain't with my girl who I thought was my world. It came out to be that she wasn't the girl for me.
Girl for me.
See, it's very find you're one of a kind, but you mash up my mind. You have to get declined, oh Lord. My baby is driving me crazy. You're way too beautiful, girl. That's why it'll never work. You have me suicidal, suicidal. When you say it's over, damn all these. Fussing and now we're fighting. Please tell me why I'm feeling slighted. And I don't know how to make it better.
Make it better.
You're dating other guys. You're telling me lies. Oh, I can't believe what I'm seeing with my eyes. I'm losing my mind. And I don't think it's clever.
Think it's clever.
You're way too beautiful. Why it'll never work. You have me suicidal, suicidal. When you say it's over, damn all these beautiful girls. They only wanna do you dirt. They'll have you suicidal, 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 suicidal.
Well, Ben, it's our last day of being underclassmen. Like, that's crazy.
I know. Well, I mean, technically we got finals, but it's our last day being underclassmen, early birds, Zach. So, yeah, next year we'll be juniors. We'll be the big dogs in the school.
Well, no, because there's going to be seniors.
Put the freshmen in their place. Whatever. We're basically seniors. We're just like smaller seniors.
Smaller seniors?
Yeah, that's what a
junior is. We're taller than most of the seniors.
That's true. That's true. We are taller. Well, I guess we just gotta roll that intro.
Salam out, Poggy Flyers, and welcome back to the Early Bird. I'm Zach Schneider, and the guy who just watched What did you just watch? I don't know, but whoever you are, you're Ben DeGroat.
I did not watch the new Spider-Man movie, in case that's what you thought, Zach, because I haven't gotten to it yet. I think something big happens at the end, but I have no idea.
Oh.
Who's your favorite superhero, Zach?
I'm a big fan of Batman. Superman.
Yeah,
of the above. I like all the good guys. What about you?
Personally, I like the Joker.
Oh, really?
Pretty
no,
cool.
Let me clarify.
He's not really a superhero.
Now, is it the Joker with the green hair? Or the Joker with the ring?
Nikola Jokic.
Oh, Nikola Jokic.
With the ring, man.
Now that...
He's on the Nuggets.
That is ironic.
He's a stud.
That is ironic because... He is a stud. But that is ironic because I brought with us today some Nikola Jokic trivia.
All right.
For the boy who just defeated the Miami Heat. All right?
Let's see it. Let's
We're going to do four.
All right.
We'll see what happens, all right? And we're going to do one afterwards.
But okay.
First one, multiple choice. How old is Nikola Jokic? A, 27, B, 26, C, 28, or D, 29?
Oh, man. You got one away from each other?
Yeah, figure it out.
I mean, I don't think he's 27. I think he's, but maybe he is. I'm going to go 27, actually. I think he's pretty young.
That is incorrect. He is 28 years old.
Oh, I was thinking 28. I was like, maybe I should go 28, but I tried 28.
I don't know. Ben's a big fan of the Joker, but doesn't know his age. All right. So, another one. What year was he drafted and what pick? All right. A, 2014, pick 41. B, 2014, pick 36. C, 2015, pick 41. Or D, 2013, pick 20.
I feel like he was the late pick. I think he was a second rounder. I'm gonna go A again.
That is correct.
Let's go, dude.
All right.
Completely guessed on that one. That was total magic.
But, all right. This one, I don't think you're gonna know. You don't know him personally like I do. You know,
oh,
I know
sure,
him pretty personally.
Sure, sure.
But what is Nikola Jokic's shoe size? Is it A, 17, B, 16, C, 18, or D, 15?
I think he's bigger than 15. You're like a 15. He's like 6'11", so he's got to be bigger than that. I'd say 17.
That is incorrect. It is a 16.
I was off by one again.
You're not doing too hot today. Man. That's all I'm gonna say. You're not doing too hot.
One for three.
All right. I've one more. This one. I don't. You might get this because whatever. But what is so? He had a great playoffs, obviously.
Yeah.
What is Nikola Jokic's average stat line in the 2023 NBA playoffs? A, 30 points per game and 12.4 rebounds per game, 10.2 assists per game. Okay, that's A.
No way.
This is a lot, okay? B, 30 points per game, 13.5 rebounds per game, and 9.5 assists per game. C, 27.9 points per game, 11.1 rebounds per game, and 10.5 assists per game. Or D, 29.3 points per game, 9.8 rebounds per game, and 8.8 assists per game. That was a lot to take in, wasn't it?
That was so much. They're all so close to each other.
That's the point.
Well, yeah, but like, I would think there would be more like variety.
There's variety.
It's so specific. No, because they're all like
right next A, to each other. B, C, or D?
All right, I'll go with B for Ben.
Why'd you get that correct?
I got it right. See what it worked.
You're such a great. Yes, that's 30 points per game in the playoffs.
Wow.
That's insane.
That's insane. Hey, I'm 50%, 2-for-4 right now.
That's also insane. You know what's even more insane?
What?
We have the pledge with my man, Logan Swift.
Life is older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze, country road.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Logan. All right, one more question.
I have one more question.
Get about 50%.
I do hear we have announcements, so we're going to see. This is make or break. Will it get you over or will it get you under 50%?
Let's go.
So this season, you know, do you have a Nikola Jokic jersey?
I do not either,
but I'm thinking of getting one.
Yeah.
But this season, what did Nikola Jokic rank in jersey sales? Okay, this is according to the NBA store. All right. Was he A, 1,
no.
B, 7, no, C, 12, and D, 5?
I feel like he, I mean, Nuggets, kind of a small market team, I think. So my guess, I would, I, I'm going to say he's outside of the top 10 and go with 12.
That is correct.
Oh, yeah. Let's go, man.
Hey, before we get too excited, that is a shout out to Jason Tatum. He was number three. Jason Tatum was
number
three.
Good job, Celtics fans. Good job. Bucks jerseys.
Way to support. But you know what else we're going to support? We're going to support the announcements.
Is having a Mad Release fundraiser on Thursday from 4 to 9. So make sure you show up and just get some ice cream and say that you're with Framingham High School Class of 2026. And we also really wanted to thank you for supporting us throughout the year. And we hope that you continue to do it with us as sophomores. Thank you.
Thanks, need to support. And you know, Ben, this is the last episode of the Early Bird Flyer News for this year. And you know, we are the only two that are like seen in front of the camera, but all of the work goes to everybody behind the camera.
Yeah.
So we actually have a big special surprise. Uh-huh. We are going to be bringing in everybody in the control room behind the camera. So everybody, come on down.
Get in here.
Come on in.
Let's go. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Come on in. Get in the shot. Let's go. Come on in.
Come on in. Fit on the couch. Oh my goodness.
This is a lot of people.
We're crowded. Come on.
Everyone come. Let's go.
Come on.
Oh yeah.
All right.
Alina, what are you doing taking pictures? Get in here.
Yeah, come on, Alina. Let's go, Alina.
Come on.
All right, we got everyone.
This is a pleasure.
You
go ahead, talk. All right, I'll talk. I think everyone's talking right now. We got everyone here. It's just great to have so many people working hard on the show and behind the scenes. And, you know, they don't often get recognized for what they do, but
we're here to recognize
them. Yeah, it's awesome what you guys contribute to this show. And we wouldn't be able to do it without you.
You know, so, yeah. So, you guys want to take us out for the year?
We'll do it early, all right? We come here early every morning. We do it early. You want to know why?
Wait. We got to give them a 3-2-1. Give them a 3-2-1. Ready?
3-2-1. Because early bird gets the worm.
Woo!
Yeah! Chill, bro.
Bro, you couldn't go against it.